Morning. Oh, Chris, there's a message from Bill McCrae's on your desk.
Cheers.
No last-minute reprieve, then?
It's not down to me anymore. She's lost it. They've all got it in for her. And after the last few days, to be quite honest, I don't blame them.
No chance she'll pull them back?
Not as far as I can see. And the longer we leave it, the more chance there is of another operation being messed up, or somebody else being hurt. You're not going to change your mind about backing me on this?
No, Jack, no. If Sally's a liability, let's get rid of her, shall we?
Oh, Gov, about last night's hijack...
Sally, I'm running late.
Yeah, but, sir, I need to talk...
Catch me later.
8:45, you said, Billy. Yeah, I'm sure it was. Right, half an hour from now, the same place as we agreed before. This better not be a wind-up. Right.
Have a word, Gov.
Yeah.
As she said, my husband's gone, but he didn't call it a truncheon.
How many inspector jokes can there be?
They're old ones.
Still get a laugh, though. What's up?
Snout called Billy McCrae. Do you remember him?
Yeah, greasy.
He phoned me first thing this morning. Said he had a sniff on the hijack.
Listen, Chris, keep me right up to speed on this one. If McCrae has got something, let's make the most of it for the home team.
If anything worthwhile, Gov, I'll let you know straight away.
Thanks. Right, listen up. Come on! Right, last night's hijack. Truckload of whiskey worth 60, 70 grand. They beat the driver up, unhitched his tractor unit, put their own one on it, and so far no one seems to have seen or heard anything. Danny, what's the score on the driver?
Looks like he's going to be unconscious for some time. The doctor said he was hit over the head with something like a baseball bat. Oh, and they gave him a kick in for good measure.
There you go. Tosh, any joy with the trailer?
Not yet, Gov.
Right, go and see the haulage contractor. Then do a tour of the local lorry parks and waste grounds, see if it's been dumped anywhere. Danny, off licences and pubs. Anyone been offered any cut-price booze recently? Jim?
Gov, I was going to go and see a few informants.
What, on the off chance?
Well, yeah, at the moment, but...
No, the pubs are more important. Anyway, Chris is already out seeing a snout. We'll try your people later if nothing else surfaces. Jim, the driver's family. See if there's any chance he might have been involved.
Gov, if he was in on it, they'd hardly have him half-killed, would they?
Maybe they had a disagreement. Find out. Alan, a tour of the transport cafes. Any rumours, gossip? Maybe we'll get lucky. Do it, people.
A tour of the lorry parks. That should be exciting.
If you're having me over...
No, no, I'm telling you.
Go on, then.
Scott's right. Could be someone selling off a load and wants rid of it fast.
I could have told you that.
Hey, okay. What I heard was this guy called Kirk pulled off a big job. Thousands of bottles.
When'd you hear this?
Last night.
Go on.
Well, the word is it's stashed on the Water Street estate.
What brand is it?
I don't know. Anyway, he's looking to sell it off fast, knock down rent. I'd have had some myself, but he only wants to shift it in bulk. No less than 10 boxes a bag.
I think you're jerking my chain. The load I'm talking about was only nicked first thing this morning. How come you heard about it last night?
Look, all I know is what I'm telling you. This bloke tipped me off in case I wanted to get myself a few balls. Who knows? Maybe they only nicked it once they got the orders in.
This bloke Kirk. Steve Kirk?
You know him?
Not personally.
Yeah, well, if you nick him, leave my name right out of it, okay?
Sierra Oscar from Deakin.
Go ahead, Sarge.
Dave, can you do me a PNC on a dark grey Granada?
Lima 221, Golf Hotel X-ray.
And a Toyota pickup Foxtrot 903 Yankee Charlie Yankee.
Stand by. Are you on that Scotch hijack from last night, Sarge?
Yep.
Well, if you need anyone
to, test the load, make sure it's a real thing, then I'm your man, yeah?
Is that test or taste, Dave?
What do you think? Here we go. Lima 221
Golf Hotel X-ray. Registered keeper shown as Stephen Lewis Kirk.
38, that's 38 Whiskin Road.
Thanks, Dave.
When I left Sunhill, there was no evidence of a problem.
Well, as I was saying to Mr. Hicks, there's no question of Dow Johnson's enthusiasm, integrity, or honesty.
But nevertheless, you've got a problem.
You know these things are like, there's a bit of a noise and it dies down after a couple of days. But this shows no signs of going away.
Is that throughout the station or just in CID?
No, it takes in a uniform as well. Over the last few months, there have been several incidents which have all led to a feeling of unease. But what brought it to a head involved a WPC, Kathy Marshall. And this lack of confidence in D.I. Johnson is beginning to have a detrimental effect on operations.
Well, Charles, you know the station. What would you say?
Well, it's usually rather a forgiving place. But if it's as serious as Jack thinks, I assume Derek Conway agrees with you.
Yes, he does, sir.
Then I think she should be moved.
All right, Jack. I think you can leave the rest to us. We'll do what we can as soon as we can.
Thank you, sir. Sir.
So, Charles, how's Miss Johnson going to respond to being taken off operations?
Well, she's ambitious. She won't want to be seen to be rocking the boat, for whatever reason. But she won't like it. She'll see it as a kind of reprimand.
Which, of course, it is. But will it cause trouble?
She's high profile, young, black, and female.
Well, down to you, Charles. What are we going to do with Inspector Johnson that isn't going to make it seem like racial or sexual discrimination?
Nobody around here seems to pay the place any attention. There is one bloke who says he thinks that the two cars were there this morning when he came in for work.
So you don't even know if they're in there or not?
Not for sure. But it is the address that McCrae gave me, and it is Kirk's car.
So they're either sitting in there with the scotch waiting for a buyer to turn up, or they've gone off someplace else. It's no good to us if we bust in there, find the scotch, and no one with it. I want this one straight down the line, Chris. Kirk and whoever else is involved caught with their hands on it.
So, we settle down and wait.
I just wish we could be sure they were in there.
There's only one way to find out.
Okay, let's set it up.
Are we going? Yeah. Don't let's be too keen, Alan. We don't want to get there first, just in case there's something she's not told us.
Like what?
Well, you never know. You've seen her when she wants a quick result. She runs over people.
Jim, in position?
Ready and waiting, Gov.
Ready?
Yeah, Gov. I'm in position.
Pierce from Johnson. Danny, are you in position? Danny!
Johnson from Carver. We've got signs of movement, Gov.
A Luton van, hotel 546, Yankee Golf Juliet. One IC, one male. Oh, are we going in, Gov?
No,
that's him. That's Steve Kirk.
That's a relief.
We could have driven him there while it was open.
What, do you want to tell her?
No, thanks, no.
Okay.
Ready when you are, Gov.
First, couldn't you, eh? Hey, you need some. Get off!
Took your bloody time.
Yeah, sorry, Gunther.
You have got a warrant, I suppose.
Chris! Chris, are you all right?
No.
What's this? Where's the rest, Chris? There was supposed to be a lorry load full. This lot wouldn't fill a shopping trolley.
So I had a few bottles of bent scotch on me. Do me for it.
No, I ain't denying it, am I?
You know this isn't just about a few bottles of stolen whiskey. This is about 100 grand's worth of stuff gone and a lorry driver in hospital with serious head injuries.
Not down to me. Told you before, a friend of a friend said he could get his hands on a few cheap bottles. I told him, right, he comes round the house and you kick the door in.
Give me the name of this friend of a friend.
No comment.
Where were you last night?
Last night? When?
All night.
Had a few drinks, played cards, went to bed.
So when did you buy the scotch?
First thing this morning, probably before you were even out of bed, darling. Early bird catches the worm. You know that.
I think we'll take a break for a few minutes. Interview terminated, 13:16.
Does that mean I'm free to go now, Mark?
Where's the rest of the stuff, Chris? If we can't find it and tie it into Kirk, he'll walk away on a charge of handling. And what's more, the cocky bastard knows it.
Don't let him get to you, Gov.
He's not getting to me. What's getting to me is your snout led us up the garden path. Now, are you going to talk to him again or what?
Yes, Gov.
Good. Let me know when you have.
Jane! Billy,
well, I don't know. I ain't just got here myself.
Well, let's have a look, shall we? Billy!
What?
You're all in trouble. Right up to here.
I don't know what you're on about. Did you get him?
Yes. But only 6 cases of scotch and no cash. And I told you what would happen if I thought you were pulling my chain, didn't I? So this is the way it goes. You've got 60 seconds to tell me what's going on, or I'm going to have a little chat with Kirk.
They must have changed the arrangements.
How did you know what the arrangements were in the first place?
Oh, come on.
How did you know?
I'll have that. Make us a cup of tea, would you?
Because I was on the job with him, all right? Happy now. Nothing serious. I was just driving one of the cars.
And?
We had a falling out. Me and Steve Kirk.
What about?
The truck driver. Kirk pulled him out of the cab and started beating him around the head with a baseball bat. I moved in. There was no need for it.
Just for a minute. I'm going to believe you're that sort of bloke. Then what happened?
Well, think about it. He had one on me, so I knew he was going to... I legged it out of there, came back here in the morning, I rang you.
So I'd nick Kirk, bang him up, and you'd be all right?
Something like that, yeah.
What happened to the scotch?
Some of the boxes went north straight away. Kirk had got a buyer set up.
What about the stuff that didn't go north?
I don't know. I legged it out of there. It could be anywhere.
Pity. Because without it, we haven't got a case. We'll have to let Kirk go.
Hold on.
Hold on!
It's a long shot, but Kirk's got a brother, Phil. He owns his plant hire place on Tarmin Street.
All right. Tell me it all again. This time with the details. Names, places, and exactly what happened from start to finish.
Chris, are you sure?
I can't be certain from here, Gov, but I reckon we've got to take a look. The place is wide open.
All right, but if this is another wild goose chase, I will personally castrate Billy McRae. Danny, you, Jim and Tosh with me in 2 minutes. Chris has got another lead on where the booze might be.
Who wants a fiver on this one being the same as the last one?
Yeah.
4 o'clock, well, I'm in the middle of an op... Yes, I'm sure they can. Right, sir, I'll see you there.
Gov, ready when you are.
Right, yeah, no. Sun has come up. Take the others and meet Chris. This is where he is.
Let's go. Everything all right?
Yes, fine. Pick up the warrant on the way, okay? Tell Chris to go ahead with the search.
Gov.
Sergeant Deakin, Sunhill. You are?
Phil Kirk. I own this place.
Nice.
We have a warrant to search your premises for stolen property.
Look, it's not mine, all right? I had nothing to do with it. I told him I didn't want it here. I come in this morning and he'd left it anyway.
Who'd left it? Your brother, Steve?
Well, no one else has got keys.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought you said he had keys.
He has. That's what I don't understand.
Go and have a look.
I come in this morning, the padlocks were on the ground here. Someone else must have cut them off.
You been in there? Kirk, I'm arresting you on suspicion of robbery. You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be given in evidence.
Oh, come on, it wasn't me. This place is legit.
Of course it is.
They must have been selling it cheap if that's all the cash they got.
Yeah.
Jim, get the socko down here, will you?
Ah, good afternoon, Sally.
Afternoon, sir. Sorry, I didn't have time to change.
Good of you to come over at such short notice. I hope it hasn't interfered with your schedule too much, but I'm afraid I've got something of a dilemma on my hands, and I'm rather hoping that you'll help me deal with it.
Sir?
Does DPRAM mean anything to you?
No, sir, I can't say that it does.
Ah, well, they are rather an unsung branch. They're the Directorate of Performance, Review and Management Services.
Oh.
Now, the situation is this. They've just lost an inspector on the PIB 5 desk. So, they need someone bright and enthusiastic with a direct experience of operations to take over immediately. And I've put your name forward.
Thank you, sir. I don't quite know what to say. I greatly appreciate the vote of confidence, but...
Entirely justified, as far as I can see from your record.
Thank you, sir. It's just that I'd be very reluctant to move away from operations at the moment. I think it's where I work best.
Well, of course, CID does have the reputation for glamour. But it's been my experience that officers who don't take the opportunity to round out their overall skills in other areas have a tendency to burn themselves out far too early. A spell away from the sharp end of things can prevent that. Take it from me, Sally. We're all very concerned that your career development should continue as satisfactorily as it has in the past.
We, sir?
Hmm. Yes, DCI Meadows, Chief Superintendent Brownlow, myself.
I see. Can I ask you something, sir?
Of course.
Are there any other reasons, apart from my career development, for this transfer?
Other reason?
Candidly, please, sir.
I am being candid. Your rise within CID operations has been a credit to you. But I believe you also need to pace yourself and take time to experience other aspects of the service. A transfer will achieve that and put you in a job where you'll be a valuable asset. I'm fully confident that in due course you will return to the front line with a much greater insight into the workings of the services as a whole.
So, what exactly is this, B?
PIB 5 desk? It's responsible for the production of performance schedules and service overtime monitoring.
Cigarette lighter? Right, Mr. Kirk, if you'd like to sign there, please. And then put in number 2, will you?
It's just a bit too neat, that's all I'm saying.
How do you mean?
Well, first raid's a bust, right? So Chris Deacon goes out, and when he calls back, we've got all the evidence we need. Nice and confident.
Come on, you don't know for sure, do you?
No, he doesn't. A word to the wise, Danny. You've all turned on the DI and made her an easy target. I'm not. I think very carefully before you start any more rumours.
Yeah?
Sorry to interrupt, Gov. Have you any idea when the DI's going to be back?
Not exactly, no. You got a problem?
Maybe, I'm not sure.
Well, come in and tell me about it.
It's a hijacking. I had a tip from a snout called McRae. Based on that, we've been in search of a place belonging to Steve Kirk's brother.
Did you find anything?
Yeah. 50 boxes of scotch. two baseball bats, one of which looks as if it's got blood on it, and 2,000 quid in 50s. By the time forensics have gone through all that stuff, I reckon there'll be enough to tie Kirk into the hijacking.
So what's the problem?
It doesn't feel right. The evidence was there. But the padlocks have been cut off the container where we found it. And I reckon it's McRae. He lied about being in on the job, and now I reckon he's lied about how much of the booze went up north last night. My guess is that most of it was sold off last night. 50 or 60,000 pounds worth.
So he used you to get rid of Kirk and took the cash?
Yeah. And I'd like to nail a little git to the floor for him. When I do...
Now, if I were you, I'd drop this one.
Get the evidence against Kirk, charge him and pass it on to the CPS. In the long term, it's not worth your while getting involved in somebody else's complications. Especially now. Just keep it neat and tidy.
I'm not sure I follow you, sir. Has this got anything to do with the DI being called to area?
It could have some bearing, yeah.
Sally. Chris.
Oh, he doesn't have to leave on my account, sir. I've just come to let you know. I've decided to accept the Assistant Commissioner's offer of a transfer.
Well, that's a good move, Sally, career-wise. Of course, we'll all miss you here.
Please. I may not be the most popular person around the station right now, but I'm not stupid. I've been hung out to dry, and we both know it. So don't add insult to injury, sir.
You must realise that there's nothing personal in this.
No, of course not. I'm sure my career prospects will benefit a great deal from the move. And as Mr. Hicks wants me to start immediately, I thought I'd clear my desk today. Don't see any point in hanging around, do you?
So, now you know.
If you come to ask me if I'd like a leaving party, the answer is no. I'm sure I'd only dampen the celebrations.
I've only just found out about it.
Oh, yeah. Bet you get acting DI, though. All boys together, eh?
Yeah. Well, sometimes it works like that.
They stitched me up. Not just Meadows and Hicks, that lot out there. But if you tried to prove anything, oh, all done by the book, Gov.
So you jumped before you were pushed. It's a smart move. You'll find your way back.
Oh, yeah. Do you know where I'm going? The bloody overtime monitoring desk.
Well, if it means anything, I think they've made a mistake.
Thanks. Chris. One DI to another.
Good working with you, Gov.